If the Bible was written so long ago, and if the words there relate to a different age and a different country, how can it possibly be relevant to me? Let's find out. G'day everyone, Brian here. Here at Heathmont Presbyterian Church, we're working our way through the book of 1 Samuel in the Old Testament. It's the book that tells the story of David becoming a king. It's the book that contains the story of David and Goliath. But tragically, it's also the story of a bloke named Saul, who was the king, who was not a good king. In the final third of that book, we find King Saul and David on wrong sides of each other. Saul is trying to kill David. David is hiding from Saul. But in the midst of this section of scripture, which contains just these stories of David and Saul fleeing, chasing, we can ask the question, how can this possibly be relevant to me? This came clear for me when I was preaching on 1 Samuel chapter 21 and wondered, what is the relevance of this? Then I realized that there are two psalms that come particularly from the events in that chapter. Here's one of them. Psalm 56. It opens like this. These little titles that we often skip over but shouldn't. For the director of music, to the tune of A Dove on Distant Oaks, of David, a miktam, when the Philistines had seized him in Gath. Now we learn that the Philistines are the enemies of Israel. David has fled there in absolute fear of Saul, and he is seized there as a prisoner. And what is his prayer? Well, as he's looking back on that time, he writes this. Be merciful to me, O God, for men hotly pursue me. All day long they press their attack. My slanderers pursue me all day long. Many are attacking me in their pride. When I am afraid, I will trust in you. In God, whose word I praise. In God I trust. I will not be afraid. What can mortal man do to me when I am afraid? In 1 Samuel 21, David hears what the king says and is afraid. And as he looks back on that time, he says those magnificent words, when I am afraid, I will trust in you. In God, whose word I praise, in God I trust, I will not be afraid. I want to encourage you today. You might be feeling afraid. You might be feeling uncertain. As I record this, Victoria continues in its lockdown. Melbourne continues in a longer lockdown. And many are afraid. Here are the words from David. God's word to us. When I am afraid, I will trust in you. I hope that you can trust in God, even in the midst of these difficult times, that you will find peace in him. Why not have a read of Psalm 56 and find your comfort there? Have a great day today. I look forward to seeing you tomorrow. Bye-bye.